Oh, hey. All right. What's up, guys? Story time with Virginia Bassett. Fish stories, if you will. And I'll try to make this short. So, yesterday, I went smallmouth fishing. I had a crappy day, and I really just wanted to go fish. I didn't record. I just want to go, no pressure, relax, go fishing, just take it easy. Learned the number one rule of YouTubing yesterday. Always, 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 always be recording. Because I caught a huge smallmouth, 22 inches, 3.1 pounds, my personal best. I just so happened to have a lady there who was walking her dog. Talked to her for like 30 minutes probably. Before I caught the fish, we were just chit-chatting, and she decided to leave, and I moved over to where she had been standing and threw out a cast, landed this guy, or hooked this guy, rather, hooked this fish. Big, big smallmouth, especially for the river, you know, that I'm fishing here, and so I kind of laughed out loud as I'm reeling on this fish, you know, and the lady heard me, and I kind of was like, hey, you guys, it's really funny, you know, I got one now that you walked away, or whatever, blah, blah, blah. And, you know, I thought it was kind of funny. You know, she watched me fish for 30 minutes, and I didn't even get a bite, and, you know, she walks away, and the next cast, I land a giant. And so, yeah. From that point, you know, I start reeling in. Realize, you know, lesson number two that I learned yesterday, which I didn't have my drag set properly anyway. I had it too tight. Got to snap the end of my rod. And completely snap the reel from the rod. This is what happens, folks, when you don't set your drag properly. Always set your drag. I didn't check it, you know. I tightened it down to break free from a really bad snag a couple of days ago, and I hadn't been out since then. Totally forgot about it. Snap. Rod goes. Reel goes. Obviously, it's the next thing. Obviously, the next thought is the fish goes. Fish is gone, right? Nope. This is why you always, always, always be recording. So, yeah. Always be recording, right? Anyway, so yeah, rod snaps, reel's gone. Just to give you an idea of what this fish is capable of, how strong he was for a little 3-pounder. On the, I guess your right, I suppose your left, is a regular Gamakatsu 2-aught worm hook offset. That's what I throw these tubes with. Here is the hook that this fish was caught on. Hope that didn't get all wacky and weird and focusy or whatever. Yeah. Check that guy out. Bent all to heck. There's a straight one out of the package. There's the hook that the fish was landed on. So I hand line this fish in. It's crazy. I know you probably don't believe it. It's cool. I get it. I probably wouldn't either if it hadn't happened. But it did. Here's some pictures. Enjoy. Alright, so, yeah, we obviously need to do a little work now, right? So, I'm on a budget. I only had a gift card to use at Walmart. Fuji rod and repair kit. We're going to use that guy to fix up the end of the rod. I only lost about that much of it. So, it's pretty much where the eyelet was connected to the tip of the rod. So, we're just going to repair it because I really like the rod. And we got a major upgrade on the reel. We go from the Walmart special, which shout out to them, really, because this reel caught a lot of fish, and I've had it for a long time. And I'm really sad that it broke, honestly. So, there is that. But we did get to replace it with this new Shimano Syncopate, which I'm really, really stoked to throw. This is the nicest reel I've ever had so far, so excited to get that out there and get to fishing with that for you guys. And for me, too. So anyway, and then a quick shout out to Zoom Plastics, because I've been slaying the smallmouths on these watermelon red tubes this week. So, man, what a great bait, at least for my area anyway. These they've been crushing them. Like I said, you know, that this big smallmouth that you were getting ready to see in this photo. Bloop, crushed this thing. So thanks, you guys. All right, so yeah, that pretty much sums it up. Always set your drag, always be recording, and really, you know, I'll never forgive myself for not having my camera on, because I feel like your line breaking and hand lining a fish in like that is a once in a lifetime thing. I really hate that I didn't catch it on film. So anyway, yeah, story time, fish stories, whatever you want to call it, with Virginia Bassin. Appreciate you guys always checking in, liking, subscribing, doing all the YouTube and things. Appreciate that. So keep tuned in, because we're going to keep shooting. So I guess till next time, guys, thank you so much. Peace.